Thank you very much. So now we'd be very happy to answer your question. It could be about everything you want about Morocco, about gas turbines, everything. It's, feel free to ask any question you want. Yes, please. When the artist starts playing the instruments, that was a question? Okay. So they all start playing the instruments at around 8 years old. Yes, please.
My apologies for the noise. It did not diminish our enjoyment of your music. So thank you.
Thank you very much. أخي يعتذر على النبوي كان واحد الصداع كيعتذر كيقول لنا Thank you, thank you for saying this.
I have a question too. Please. I've never seen violin play the lead before. I see two violins have shin holders. Did you learn this way or did you learn this way?
Okay, I'm translating your question. In Arabic? Do you speak Arabic?
All students.
Okay, but you know some words in Arabic. Okay, so we do everything in the mic. That sounds good. That sounds better. Well, أخي سول كيفاش فين تعلمتوا تلعبوا على الكباب؟
Oops, that was a flash.
موسيقى.
موسيقى
قديمة تحصل على الشعبية
For the next question. Well, it's the way they play the instruments, it's a very, very old way of playing. Very ancient. It's from the 13th century. The medieval era. So that was the way they used to play the music. And what is interesting is that the Fez Orchestra preserved this heritage. As I said in the introduction, it's the heritage of the Andalusian era. And now they keep many things from that time, that period.
الموسيقى باش ملاحظة الموسيقى مختلفة عن الموسيقى العربية اللي كتجي في مصر في تركيا في سوريا اللي عندها نمط آخر خد عن نمط غربي في المقامات ديالها.
So just one detail, this music is different from the Middle Eastern music. It's not the same. This music is closer to the Western music in terms of musical mode.
في الموسيقى اللي هنا كاين لو ميتون وفي الموسيقى العربية كاين لو كارد دو تون.
So in their music there is demi-ton, which is half it's a half ton, and in the Middle Eastern music there is quarter ton. Any other question, please? Yes.
So usually in today's music, the drummer keeps the tempo, keeps the beat, but I didn't notice that. Like
the percussionist didn't keep the tempo, but it seems like you followed the others.
Was that right?
Okay, so the question is about how they harmonize the way of playing, right? That was the question. الأخ كيسول إلى هل يعني عموما كيكون البيكسون اللي كتشيل التيمبو ولكن هو راح يكون كتلعب واحد الطريقه شويه مختلفه يعني كاين شنو هو السر يعني شنو هو
الموسيقى ديالنا كما قلنا عندها واحد كتقترب واحد النوع ديال الجاز النوع ديال الامبروفيزاسيون.
So the Andalusian music is close of like jazz, there's a sound of jazz on it.
عندما احنا بالقسم العازفين ديال الكماجه كاين عندنا واحد
For example, for the artist playing the kamanja, violin, So there is a melody, but in the melody there is a part of improvisation.
دائما ما يسمى يعني شاب اوركستر هو اللي كيعطي الموفمنت كرونوميك بالنسبه للايقاع شوفوا الطرب.
So it's the maestro. It's the maestro who's giving the ايقاع like the melody to the طرب. So as this enemy. So there is a permanent communication, there is eye contact. It's very, very important. Yep, it's very important. The eye. Okay, another point is that good music is also transmitted orally, used to be transmitted orally from many centuries ago. Just orally, initiated orally. It wasn't written at that time.
والمدة الزمنية ديالها فوق 100 ساعة القيمة ديالها.
And the length of the Andalusian music is over 100 ساعة. Yeah, it's 100 hours, over 100 hours. Yeah, this, they do speak some words in Arabic, so we want to learn Arabic from you. The words you give us everything.
تتكلموا العربية؟ تتكلموا العربية؟
هل تتكلموا العربية؟
شنو؟ شوية. هذه لا عربية فصحى. هذه الموسيقى الأندلسية هي الموسيقى الأندلسية المغربية هي موسيقى قديمة والقيمة اللحنية تتجاوز 100 ساعة. فيها الشعر وفيها غناء وفيها موسيقى يعني ريبرتوار طويل جدا. يلزم
مرحبا بك في الكونسير بيرفورمانس فرايداي في الجمعة. مرحبا بك ان شاء الله. Yes, please. In short.
Was the music primarily sung in Mushaf or any Moroccan style? Was it all sung in Mushaf or any Moroccan
style? The lyrics of the music? أخ كتسول واش الموسيقى باللغة الكلاسيكية ولا بالدارجة؟ أغلب
الأشعار هي باللغة الكلاسيكية، أشعار شعراء من القدماء.
Most of the poems are in classical Arabic. From the medieval era.
وكاين بعض الأشعار القديمة اللي هي بالدارجة ديالنا اللي تسمى بروال. المصطلح العامي في المدرسة.
And there are some lyrics or poems in dialects, Arabic dialects, that are called بروال.
بروال. بروال. بروال.
بروال. Yes, please. Very good question. What about women? ما أين هما النساء؟ أين هما الفام؟
موجودين في
الموسيقى. موجودين. We do have women. They do have women in the music in the orchestras also. Yeah. Of course, there are teachers in Asetida. There are teachers in the conservatories in Morocco. There are as Mr. Bimo just told this morning. There is more than 60% in his conservatory women and 40% men. So they are very present in the Andalusian art of music. Other question, please. What is the most important part of the album? La, هي كلها قديمة. You talk about lyrics, right?
الحن كل
music لا الحن.
الحن كلها قديمة. من الملحنين مجهولين غير معروفين.
الملحنين المجهولين means the people who made the melodies are unknown. You know the oldest ones, so they are unknown. So Jamal Eddin has written notation, you know, musical mode with Mr. Rewal. That was in around since the 70s, nothing was transcripted regarding this melodies. That was just orally, as we mentioned. Until you know, in Morocco, Mr. Rewal is the first one who got this idea, and it took him 10 years, 10 years, in short, and the Hifad al Tawras to conserve this traditional musical heritage. And it's a part of our work. I don't know. Another question, please?
Yes, please.
The influence of Berber music, Berber culture on the kind of music you're
Very good question. What about the influence of Moroccan of Berber in the music?
L'influence de la Berberia sur la musique andalouse.
So we have a maqam that is called Shouk Dew.
Khumasid
is there is five parts of it. It is called Pontatoni. So we do have another story. If actually, the Berber music is very close to Chinese. When you hear them, like I'm talking about Moroccan Berber, when you hear them play, it seems like Chinese. So the maqam we have to study the result of the third year of the
four messages.
Okay, here we play a maqam for you.
Soyez
le bienvenu. Marhaba bikoum fi Maghreb.
المغرب يعني من الحضارة القديمة يعني الفاسي من 12 قرن.
It's a very ancient civilization.
تواصل الحضارة ما بين الحضارة القديمة ونحن في الحضارة الجديدة. يعني البعض يكمل البعض. هذا هو استمرارية يعني التواصل فيما بيننا.
So is saying that tawassul means there is a complementarity between the old civilization, like for example, Fez is 12th century, and here in the US it's like two or three, almost three century. So there is a kind of complementarity and continuation. This is. Yes, please.
Yeah, you said that the music goes back to the 13th century. Can you give me a bit of today's music? So that I can compare to the
You're talking about the music from the 3rd century?
No, I mean, you said this music goes back to the 13th century, right?
Mm-hmm.
And now I'd like to hear a little bit of today's music from Fez or in Morocco in general.
Today's music, إحنا قلنا بأن الموسيقى في الجدرة الوطنية للقرن الثالث عشر وبعد سنة مش حاجة جديدة يعني بلو ريسون.
عندنا واحد الرسالة ان احنا واحد كنا نحمل واحد الهوية ديال البلاد ديالنا التراثية جزء من الهوية ديال البلاد ديالنا يعني هذا هو التخصص ديالنا واخا اننا كنعزفوا الموسيقى
الجديدة
ولكن ملزم علينا ان نحتفظ على الموسيقى ديالنا كتعرف انها تتوارث بالهوية الشفوية وإلا ما احتفظنا عليها
ستتوارث. So Mr. Newell is saying that it's a very old music, and they are carrying a risala, which is a message. This message, they are carrying also their huwiya, which is identity, you know. And the rule is really to preserve this heritage, because since it was transmitted orally, so it's really sacred for them, you know, to keep it the old way. Even though they know how to play new music, you know, new world.
خاص في عصر العولمة والتطور يعني غادي في يمكن هذا الشيء واحد النهار اللي غادي ما احتفظناش بهذا الشيء.
So since also we live in a kind of globalization, everything is running fast, so it really needs a conservation, a preservation. It has to be preserved as much as we can.
والتطور بس أساس بعيد. الموسيقى الحالية اللي نحن سمعناها مثلا 20 سنة أو 30 سنة ما غنلقاوش التطور اللي حاصل الان يعني هو اساس قراوا الموسيقى العربيه وحاولوا دخلنا التقنيات في العزف التقني استعملنا في الموسيقى اللي عطانا واحد الحده جديده اكاديميه يعني ماشي التاريخ تاع شحال هذه القديمه كاين تطور كبير.
So also even the music is very old those are actually teachers in the conservatory Jamal professors you know so they study also western music and they add some things from the Western music to their ancient music. Yes, please.
And one last question. In the themes of the words to your songs, it was sort of repeated over and over again about the person's love being distant from them, like with the sun going down, they're getting further away. Is this related to any kind of ideas of Sufism of the love and the beloved and the lover and all that kind of?
اوكي الاخ كيسول على بالنسبه لك الشمس العشي الفات باش انك غروب الشمس كيعبر على حاله بعاد على الحبيبه ديالك او الحبيب كيقول واش كاين بحال شي يعني هذا البروفير او هذا الشعر واش كاين شي اندماج معاه او شي بوان كوما مع الصوفيا يعني الشعر الصوفي او يعني الشعر
هذا هذه النوبه المايا على علاقه بالشعر الصوفي يعني فيها يعني الغروب في علاقه الحبيب في الحزن في يعني في الاسى في بزاف الاشياء.
So this is this music is Nubat al-Maya. It's called Nubat al-Maya. And it talks about distance, getting far from the Habib, the beloved, sadness also. You know? It's a natural imagery that is expressed like this. But it's not really related to a poem from Sufis or and there are some poems in Sufi poems in the Andalusian music, yes.
Of course.
And these melodies we can adapt Sufi poems on that melodies. They are adaptable. piece of your work, if you another before we finish.